Okay, we have our prepress eye cut or sheet that we're going to nest up. To begin with, we have our image link, and we're going to prepare our image link to be a production link that we're going to feed into our file. We have our cut folder, we have our print folder, and we have our work folder. So everything is organized so everybody can find the files that they need. So inside our work folder, we have our production links folder. That PDF is going to be our single one-up PDF with the proper bleed. And that link is what we are going to place in to our file that we are going to nest together. So we are going to open up our blank Illustrator file. And right now it is sized to the sheet. We're going to go to Document Setup to edit artboards, and we're going to bring up our artboard size. And it is already sized to our sheet of material, which is 96 by 48. We have our art layer. We're going to go to File, Place, and we're going to grab that PDF into our Production Links subfolder. So we're going to click on that, and then we're going to import to the bleed setting. We're going to place that in there, and then we're going to center it to the sheet. We're going to make a new layer. We're going to call it through cut. We're going to go and we're going to assign this to be a stroke, no fill, and we're going to tag that stroke to be a swatch, to be our through cut. We're going to add a thickness to it, a 0.2 thickness, and we're going to size it, and this size is going to be our die line. Our die line is going to be 28 by 22, and that's the size that we need exactly for it to be cut. We're going to center the die line. So now we have our artwork centered. We have our die line centered, and right now it's one up. So we're going to take that, we're going to select both of them, and we're going to group them together. Then with that group selected, we're going to move it back down to the artwork layer. And we're going to force it to be in the top left corner of our artboard, which our artboard is our sheet of material. Then we are going to transform and move and do a copy down with enough space in the middle, so usually about a half inch space. And then we're going to select both of those, and then we're going to move them to the right, and we're going to fill out the rest of our sheet. So this artwork is pretty big, so we're only going to get about six up onto a sheet. We're going to select all of our groups, and we're going to group them again. And then we're going to center that to the width and height, so center it directly to the artboard. And then we're going to ungroup. We're going to open up this artwork layer. We're going to ungroup everything, so it's just the die line and just the link file. Then we're going to target select one of the die lines. We're going to go to Select, Same, and Fill and Stroke. And that's going to select all the die lines on that layer. And then we're going to target select that and then move that up to our through cut layer. So now we have our artwork on one layer. We have our through cut die lines on one layer. We're going to make a new layer. We're going to call this Register. And these are where we're going to place our registration marks. And to help place our registration marks, we're going to select our artwork and our die line. We're going to go up to Object, Artboards, and we're going to Fit to Selected Art. So we're bringing our artboard to be our selection. Then we're going to go back to our artboard settings. We're going to deselect, and we're going to add 1 inch to the width and 1 inch to the height. And that gives us a little bit more white space around our 6-up print. We're going to go and we're going to change our fill to be black. We're going to make a circle, and we're going to make a 1/4 inch circle. And this size, the 1/4 inch black circle, is pretty standard for a registration mark. And then we're going to take that, and then we're just going to place it and force align it to the top left corner. We're going to copy that circle, and then we're going to paste it, and then we're going to force align that to the bottom left corner. Then we're going to paste it again and force it to the bottom right corner. And again, we're going to paste it and place it in the top right corner. And then we're going to take the top circle, we're going to transform and duplicate it and move it 2 inches to the left. So then we have our locator dot. Then we're going to deselect, and we're going to go back to our artboard settings, 1 inch addition to the width and the height. And this 1 inch extra will help make the registration marks not on the edge of our print. So it gives us a little bit of white space. So we're going to go to File, Save As. And we're going to give it a name. So this is our working Illustrator file that's nested up to be 6-up. And we're going to save this right into our work folder. And then we're also going to copy the file name that we just made. We're going to zoom in on the top right corner. We're going to select our art layer. We're going to select our text tool. Then we're going to paste in our file name. So this will help us have the print name on our print that we're printing out. So we're going to save again. Then we're going to turn off our die line. And we're going to save our print file. So we're going to go to the print folder. Save as a PDF. And our preset, we're going to do a PDF X4. We're going to click OK. And then it's done saving, we're going to click OK. We're going to turn on our through-cut layer. We're going to select our artwork, and we're going to delete the artwork layer. So now we're ready to make our cut file, and our cut file is just the register layer and just the through-cut layer. So we're going to place this file into our cut folder. So we don't want to save two PDFs with the same name. So we're going to adjust our cut name. We're going to save the preset as Illustrator default. And save our cut file. So we started out with a single PDF into our production links layer, nested it up to be a working 6-up Illustrator file. Then we have our PDF print file, and then we have our cut file, and each one in its own sublayer for easy navigation. So this same process can be modified for any artwork and any die line, and really any sheet size.